एग्जाम्पल नंबर 10 फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 फ्रॉम द प्रॉब्लम सेट 6. द क्वेश्चन इज वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट साइन थीटा माइनस कॉस थीटा प्लस 1 अपॉन साइन थीटा प्लस कॉस थीटा माइनस 1 इट इज इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन सेक थीटा माइनस टेन थीटा. वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द एल एच एस एंड आर एच एस आर इक्वल. सो हियर वी विल राइट एल एच एस एज इट इज and the LHS is sin theta minus cos theta plus 1 upon sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. This is LHS, and simplifying this we have to get the RHS, that is 1 upon sec theta minus tan theta. So this is the important example. As compared to all other 9 examples, you have to remember the solution carefully where we have to do, which things we have to do there, which identities we have to use there. It is very important. So we write here LHS as it is. Now here neither we have to do the rationalization of numerator or nor we have to do the rationalization of denominator. But the very important thing we have to do, that is first we'll write this as it is sin theta minus cos theta plus 1 upon sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. Now here we have to take the minus sign common from these two terms in the numerator. We have to take the sign minus sign common from the first two terms, and once we take the minus sign common we will get inside the bracket what we will get there. If we take minus sign common from these two terms we will get into the bracket cos theta minus 1. That is very important. We put sin theta as it is, and from these two terms we take minus sign common, and inside the bracket what is remaining there? Cos theta minus 1. And see, into the denominator we have sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. The terms which we have in the numerator, same terms we have into the denominator. Here we have minus sign and here we have plus sign. Now we will multiply the numerator by sin theta plus cos theta minus 1, and we will multiply the denominator also by the same term, that is sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. It is very important adjustment. This is very important adjustment. We as it is take this denominator, this sin theta plus cos theta minus 1, sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. We multiply the numerator by the same number and we multiply the denominator by the same number. And here we have to take the multiplication, and you can easily complete the multiplication. Since the numerator is in the form a plus b and a minus b, this numerator is in the form a plus b and a minus b, so you can multiply it as a square minus b square, and see the denominator sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 multiplied by sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. Same number is multiplied by the same number, so you have to take the square of that number. Suppose we have 7 multiplied by 7, so you have to write it 7 square. So here we have sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 multiplied by sin theta plus cos theta minus 1, that is the same term. So we have to take the square of that number, square of the denominator, and there we have to use the square expansion of the sum of the three terms. So in the numerator we will get, see the numerator, it is in the form a plus b and a minus b, so you can write it as a square minus b square. We write the numerator in the form a square minus b square, and now into the denominator we have to take the square expansion, same term multiplied by the same term, same expansion, same trigonometric expression multiplied by the same trigonometric expression. So you have to take the square of that trigonometric expression, that is sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 whole square. Now you have to simplify this, square of the first term, that is sin square theta minus into the bracket, we have to take the square expansion of this bracket, that is cos square theta minus 2 cos theta plus 1, square of the first term, sine of the middle term, product of both the terms and twice of it, plus square of the second term, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square, that is the square expansion of difference of the two terms, divided by. Now, here we have to write the square expansion of the three terms, that is a plus b plus c bracket square, a plus b plus c bracket square. And how to write a plus b plus c bracket square? It is very easy. A plus b plus c bracket square, the expansion is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. If we have the expression in this form, that is a plus b plus c whole square, then you have to write it into the form a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 into product of the first two plus 2 into product of the second and term plus third plus 2 into product of the first and third. So, here you have to write the expansion of the sin theta plus cos theta minus 1, and you can write it as, see, the sin square theta plus cos square theta plus first term square, second term square, third term square, that is 1. Now, we have to take the product of these two and twice of it. We have to take the product of first and second and twice of it, that is plus 2 into sin theta cos theta. Then we have to take the product of these two and twice of it, that is minus 2 cos theta. And then we have to take the product of these two and twice of it, that is minus 2 sin theta, minus 2 sin theta. And now we have to simplify this again. See, sin square theta remains as it is, minus into plus minus, that is cos square theta, minus into minus, it is plus 2 cos theta, minus into plus, that is minus 1, divided by. Here you can write sin square theta plus cos square theta as 1 plus, this one remains as it is, plus 2 sin theta into cos theta minus 2 cos theta minus 2 sin theta minus 2 cos theta minus 2 sin theta. Now, we have to make some changes in the numerator. Since we have sin square theta, rather all the ratios, rather all the terms have cos theta, just we have here sin theta. So, we will replace it and we will use the value of sin square theta in the form of cos theta, and that will be sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. We replace this value sin square theta by 1 minus cos square theta, remaining all the terms as it is, that is minus cos square theta plus 2 cos theta minus 1, divided by 1 plus 1 is 2, is 2 plus 2 sin theta into cos theta minus 2 cos theta minus 2 sin theta. You can take 2 as common. Here plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled. We have 2 cos theta minus 2 cos square theta minus 1 minus 1, that is minus 2 cos square theta. So, you can write this as 2 cos theta minus 2 cos square theta divided by, this 2 cos theta as it is, minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 cos square theta divided by. We have to take 2 common from all these 4 terms, 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms. So, you take 2 common, and what is inside the bracket remaining? It is 1. Nothing is there is means we have 1 there plus sin theta into cos theta minus cos theta only minus sin theta only. As we take 2 common, only cos theta and sin theta is remaining there. Here also we can take 2 common, and cos theta also you can take common. 2 cos theta you can take common from the numerator. You can take 2 cos theta common from the numerator. So, inside the bracket 1 minus cos theta is remaining, divided by this 2 into the bracket 1 and cos theta. We will take closure. We will take these two terms closure, 1 minus cos theta. Then, so we will write minus sin theta and then we will write plus sin theta into cos theta. We change the order. We change the order of the trigonometric ratios. And why we change the order? That is very important thing. Why we write 1 and minus cos theta nearest to each other? Because see, we have 1 minus cos theta into the numerator. And suppose if we are able to take 1 minus cos theta common from all these terms, then 1 minus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta gets cancelled. And it is become easy to us to get the RHS. Nothing is there in the numerator, just we have 1 there. Here 2 gets cancelled, but what about this 1 minus cos theta? So, for cancelling this 1 minus cos theta, we have to try to get 1 minus cos theta in the denominator also. So, here we take 1 and minus cos theta to nearest to the each other, and then we write this minus sin theta and plus sin theta into cos theta. And now, from these two terms, we can take minus sin theta common. And what is remaining there in the denominator, that we have to see carefully. See, this 2 gets cancelled. Now here only we can get cancelled. This 2 gets cancelled. And what is the remaining there in the numerator? What is remaining there in the numerator? See, we will cancel this 2. In the numerator we have cos theta into the bracket 1 minus cos theta divided by is 1 minus cos theta, as it is 1 minus cos theta, as it is. You can write it into the simple bracket, is 1 minus cos theta into the simple bracket. Now from these two terms we have to take sin theta common. Minus sin remains as it is, sin theta is taken common. So what is remaining there inside the bracket? We have 1 minus cos theta. We have 1 minus cos theta. Simple bracket close, rectangular bracket close. Now here we have this cos theta into the bracket 1 minus cos theta. Now see, we have 1 minus cos theta here, we have 1 minus cos theta here. So you can take 1 minus cos theta common from these two terms, 1 and 2 terms. From these two terms you can take 1 minus cos theta common. And once you take 1 minus cos theta common, what is remaining there inside the second bracket? We have nothing is here. 1 minus cos theta is taken common. So we have 1 there minus sin theta. Now this is 1 minus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta gets cancelled. We have cos theta upon 1 minus sin theta. We have cos theta upon 1 minus sin theta. Now we get the simplest form of the LHS, that is cos theta upon 1 minus sin theta. Now what we need in the RHS? We need 1 in the numerator and we need sec theta minus tan theta in the denominator. But we have cos theta here. So how to get 1 there? So you will divide this cos theta by cos theta. So you will get 1 into the numerator. And if we divide the numerator by cos theta, then definitely we have to divide the denominator by also cos theta. So here we will divide numerator by cos theta. That is cos theta upon cos theta. See, it is very important adjustment. Very important adjustment you have to think about carefully. We need 1 here. So we divide this cos theta by cos theta since we get 1 there. But once you divide the numerator by cos theta, then definitely we have to divide the denominator by cos theta. So here we will write 1 upon cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta. We divide the denominator by cos theta and we separate the denominator. denominator 1 minus sin theta, we divide it by cos theta and we separate the denominator, that is 1 upon cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta, and here we get this cos theta upon cos theta is 1 divided by 1 upon cos theta is sec theta minus sin theta upon cos theta is tan theta, which is RHS. So here you can write LHS is equals to RHS. This is very important example, and easily we simplify the example. See, the adjustment in the first steps are very important. From the numerator we take minus sign common, and then we multiply numerator and denominator both by the same number. Here we neither take the rationalization of numerator nor the denominator. As it is, by this denominator we multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. We didn't change anything there. By the same number we multiplied numerator and denominator, and then we simplify it and we get 1 upon sec theta minus tan theta, which is RHS. So this is all about the example number 10. It is very important example. From this question we will take next question, next examples. Question number 6 from the problem set 6. The question is, we have a word problem here. A boy is standing at a distance of 48 meters from a building. If he observes the top of the building, the angle of elevation of 30 degrees is made there. The angle of elevation of the 30 degrees made there. So find the height of the building. We have to find the height of the building. It is given that a boy is standing at a distance of 48 meters from a building. So first of all, we will represent a building by the segment. This is a building, let it be building, we will represent it by the segment AB. And a boy is standing 48 meter away from this building. This distance is 40 meter away. And let it be point C, where the boy is standing. From this, he observes the top of the building and he gets the angle of elevation, that is of 30 degree. This is the building, segment AB is a building. Point C, the position of a boy, that boy observes the top of the building and he gets the angle of elevation of 30 degree there. If that boy is 48 meter away from the building, find the height of the building. Here we represent the situation which is given into the example by using a diagram. We have three steps in all. In the first step we have to draw the diagram, in the second step we have to describe the diagram, and into the third step we have to write the information whatever we have available here, and we have to use the trigonometric ratio to find the required information. So we draw the diagram here. Now you will describe, we will describe the diagram. Seg AB is a building. Seg AB is a building. Point C. Point C is a boy. Point C is a boy. And seg BC, that is the distance between the boy and building. Seg BC is distance between boy and building. So this is the description of this diagram, and now we have to write the information which we have available here. We have in the above figure, in the above figure we have BC is equal to 48 meters, angle ACB is equal to 30 degree, and we have to find AB, length of the segment AB. And now we have to use the trigonometric ratio, but we have 6 trigonometric ratios in all. Which ratio we have to use here? So first see the angle which we have given, either it is angle of elevation or it is angle of depression. Now see, we have given the angle of elevation, we know the adjacent side of this angle, and we have to find the opposite side of that angle. So definitely we have to use either tan or cot ratio. We cannot use another ratio. We will use the ratio, but we cannot get these sides which we need to find. If you want to find AB, then just we have to think about tan or cot ratio, because we know the adjacent side and we have to find the opposite side, and we have two ratios. We have two ratios corresponding to the opposite side and adjacent side, that is tan or cot. So we write here tan 30 in right triangle, in right angle triangle ABC, tan 30 degree is equals to opposite side AB upon adjacent side BC. This is tan 30, value of tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. It is equals to, we have to find AB and we know BC, that is 48. So we write 48 here. Now take the cross multiplications to get the value of AB. We will get root 3 into AB is equal to 48. And transfer this root 3 to the right side, we will get AB is equal to 48 upon root 3. And now you have to rationalize the denominator. Multiply the numerator by root 3 and multiply the denominator by root 3. So we have AB is equal to 48 into root 3 divided by 3, that is root 3 into root 3 is 3. Divide this 48 by 3, we will get 16 there. So we have AB is equals to 16 root 3 meters. That is the height of the building. It is 16 root 3 meter. And if you have given the value of root 3, you can put that value there. And again, we have to simplify it. But the value of square root of 3 is not given in this example. We know the value of root 3 is 1.73. But we do not have to use that value, because that is not given into the question. If it is given in the question, then we have to use that value. So here our answer is gets completed, and the height of the building is 16 root 3 meters. So here we will write the answer. Height of the building is 16 root 3 meters. So this is all about the question number 6. Now we will take the next question, that is question number 7. Question number 7 from the problem set 6. It is again a world problem, and the question is, from the top of a lighthouse, an observer looks at a ship and he founds the angle of depression of 30 degree. From the top of a lighthouse, an observer looks at the ship and he founds the angle of depression of 30 degree. If the height of the lighthouse is 100 meter, then find how far is that ship from the lighthouse. If the height of the building is 100 meters, sorry, the height of the lighthouse is 100 meters, then how far is that ship from the lighthouse? So here we have to represent the situation by using the diagram in the first step, then we have to describe the diagram in the second step, and into the third step, using the trigonometric ratio, we have to get the answer of our question. So first we will draw the diagram. In the diagram, we have given a lighthouse. Let it be a lighthouse. On the top of this lighthouse, an observer is there. Suppose this point represents observer. This is the lighthouse. We will represent this lighthouse by using the segment PQ. on the top of this lighthouse and observe what is there. On the top of this lighthouse and observe what is there. And if he observes a ship, if he observes a ship from the top of the lighthouse on the ground, if he observes a ship and finds the angle of depression to be 30 degrees, here we get the angle of depression, this is horizontal line and this is angle of depression which measures 30 degrees. This lighthouse is perpendicular to the ground or floor, and here this point represents a ship, this point represents an observer, and this PQ is the lighthouse, which is 100 meters in height. The height of the lighthouse is 100 meters. So this is the diagram. Now we have to write the description in this diagram. Segment PQ is a lighthouse. Then point Q is an observer. This point R, is a ship, and since we have to find this distance, we will represent that here also. We will describe that distance also. Say PR is distance between the ship and lighthouse. Say PR is distance between ship and lighthouse. So this is the description of this diagram. Now if this angle measures 30 degrees, then definitely this angle measures 30 degrees. So we draw the diagram. We will represent one more point here to write the name of this angle. We will represent this point by S. We have given that angle SQR is equal to 30 degrees, and since angle PRQ becomes 30 degrees, as they are alternate angles made by the transversal of two parallel lines. This is horizontal line QS. Now here the information, whatever we have available in the form of numbers, numerical information, we have to write there. This is PQ is equal to, in the above figure, PQ is equal to 100 meters. In angle SQR is equal to PRQ is equal to 30 degree. Angle SQR equals to angle QRP equals to 30 degree. Reason is alternate angles. Now we have to find this distance, segment PR. See, we have opposite side and we have to find adjacent side. So again we have to use either tan or cot ratio. So we will use the tan ratio in right angle triangle QPR. QPR is tan 30 is equals to, tan 30 degree is equals to, how to write tan ratio? Opposite side PQ upon adjacent side PR. Put the values there. Tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. It is equal to PQ is 100 upon PR we have to find. So this PR remains as it is. And now take cross multiplications. PR into 1 is PR. It is equal to 100 multiplied by root 3. So PR is equal to 100 into root 3. That is the distance of the ship from the lighthouse. And again here we do not have the value of root 3. And if it is given, we have to put that value there. is 1.73. If it is given in the question, we have to put that value there. This is 1.73, and then we have to take multiplication, and we will get 173 meter is the distance between the ship and lighthouse, but the value of root 3 is not given into the question. So, we are not going to use the value of root 3. So, final answer is the distance of ship from the lighthouse is 100 into root 3 meters. The distance of a ship from the lighthouse is 100 root 3 or 100 into root 3 meters. So, that is all about the example number 7, question number 7. We will take the next question, that is question number 8. Question number 8 from the problem set 6. The question is, two buildings are in front of each other on a road of width 15 meter. If from the first building, which is 12 meter high, if from the first building we observe the top of the second building, the angle of elevation of 30 degree is to be found. If from the top of the first building we observe the top of the second building, the angle of elevation found to be 30 degree, then find the height of the second building. We have to find the height of the second building. So, here first of all we will represent the situation in the question by using the diagram. Here we have two buildings are in front of each other. We have two buildings in front of each other on a road of 15 meter width. Suppose this is road of width having 15 meter, and for if we observe height of the first building is 12 meter, if we observe the top of the second building from the top of the if we observe the top of the second building from the top of the first building, the angle of elevation found to be 30 degree. This is angle of elevation from the top of the first building towards the top of the second building, that is measures 30 degree, that is given information. And now here we have to find the height of the second building. As we know that each and every object which is given into the example, we have to consider that it is always perpendicular to the floor or the ground. So, here both the buildings are perpendicular to the ground. Here it is given that this angle is 30 degree. Here is the observer. If we observe the top of the second building from the top of the first building, the angle of elevation is found to be 30 degree. If height of the first building is 12 meter, then find the height of the second building. This angle measures 90 degree as they are corresponding angles made by the transversal of two parallel lines. Here, already we solved two examples before this into the practice set 6.2. Here we have two buildings. In that example, we have two poles erected on the ground. Also, we have two buildings also in an example from the practice set 6.2. The same example we have here, just the numbers are numerical values are changed only. And here we have to represent, we have to give the names to these buildings. Building first building AB, we'll represent second building as CD, we'll represent this point as E. Now we have to describe the diagram, we have to write the description. Say AB is a building, Sig CD is another building, or you can represent it as second building, and Sig AC is a road. Sig AC is a road of width 15 meter. This is all about the description. Now the numerical values which we have, that we have to write here in the above figure. In the above figure we have AB is equals to 12 meter. We have AC is equals to 15 meter. We have angle DBE is equal to 30 degree. And we have to find the value of CD, that is the height of the second building, but the CD is nothing but that is CE plus DE, and we know the CE. If this side measures 12, this is 12, this much distance is 12 meter CE. Opposite sides of rectangles BACE is rectangle, two sides are perpendicular to each other or parallel to each other, and one angle is right angle. Since it is rectangle, opposite sides of rectangle are congruent. If this side measures 15, this is 15, and now you can easily find DE by using the tan ratio, and then DE plus CE is nothing but the height of the second building. It is too easy. So we have the numerical values that we write here. Before using this triangle to find the length of DE, we have to write that this is, this quadrilateral is rectangle, and in this quadrilateral we have AB is equal to CE and AC is equal to BE, that we have to write here. So we will write quadrilateral BACE, quadrilateral BACE is a rectangle. Since we can write AB is equal to CE is equal to 12 meters, and you can write AC is equal to BE is equal to 15 meters, and the reason is opposite sides of a rectangle, opposite sides of a rectangle. Now we have to use this triangle, right angle triangle BED, and in this triangle we have to find DE first. So we'll write here in right triangle BED, in right triangle BED we know the adjacent side, it is 15 meter, and we have to find opposite side. So we'll use tan ratio there. Tan 30 is equals to opposite side DE upon adjacent side BE. Put the values there. Tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. DE we have to find, and BE is 15. So BE is equal to 15. So take the cross multiplications, we have DE into root 3 is equal to 15 into 1 is 15. So we have DE is equal to 15 upon root 3. Now we have to rationalize the denominator, and then we will get DE is equals to 15 root 3 upon 3, it is 3 5 is 15. We have DE is equal to 5 root 3, DE is equals to 5 root 3 meters, but this is not the height of the second building. The height of the second building is CD. And how we have to get this length CD, that is CE plus DE. So you can write that part here. CD is equals to DE plus CE. And the reason is E is in between D and C. E is in between D and C. Put the values there. This is 12 plus 5 root 3. DE is 5 root 3. And CE is 12. So total height of the second building is 12 plus 5 root 3, or you can represent it as 5 root 3 plus 12. So we will write the final answer into the word height of the second building. Height of the second building is 12 plus 5 root 3 meters. So this is all about the example number 8. We will take next question, that is question number 9.